In this video, we're going to start the KutaSoftware Infinite Geometry free worksheet, Altitudes of Triangles Constructions. In numbers 1 through 4, our directions are to construct the altitude from vertex A. Now, an altitude is a line that goes from the indicated vertex, or essentially from any vertex, although in this case we're going to be using vertex A, to the opposite side. However, when it intersects that opposite side, it is perpendicular to that side. So in number 1, we have to find a line that's perpendicular to this opposite segment, however, it goes through point A, or vertex A. So in order to do that, let me extend this opposite side so we have a little more room to work. Now I'm going to take my compass, place it on vertex A, and extend out so that I can intersect the line. And I'll intersect it at one point, and then I'll move my compass around so that I can intersect it at another point. For my next step, those intersection points, I can assume that they create a segment, and now in order to find a line that's perpendicular and runs through point A, I'm just going to have to find a perpendicular bisector of that short segment I created. Since I based those intersections off point A, I know that A is halfway in between. So, when I make my perpendicular bisector, lining my compass up a little more than halfway, and then going to the other end point, the other intersection I created, keeping that measurement the same on my compass, I'll get a point that's going to be on that line that's perpendicular that goes through point A. So now I'll just draw this, lining up A and that intersection point. I'll draw it to the segment, but I will not continue on through that intersection point. I'll just stop at that segment. And that's how you create an altitude. Let's do the same in number 2. Again, I'm going to extend this side that's opposite A, so I have a little more room to work. Now I'm going to create 2 points that are the same distance from vertex A that lie on that line segment that I just extended. Now that I have those, I'm going to adjust my compass so that's a little more than half the distance between those 2 points. I'm going to make a mark to one side of the line from one of those intersection points, and then putting my compass on that other intersection point, making another mark to that same side of the segment. Now that I have my intersection, I can line that up with vertex A and draw my segment that will be perpendicular to the side that's opposite A, which will be my altitude. And number 3, going through the same steps, except I'm not going to extend the side opposite A because I have a lot of room to work with. So from vertex A, I'm going to strike a mark and strike another mark, and then moving my compass to a little more than half of that distance, setting it on one intersection point, I'm going to make an arc, and then moving it to that other intersection point, essentially the endpoints of that new segment, strike another mark. Now I'll line my straight edge up from A to that intersection point, and then draw my altitude that will be perpendicular to this side. And number 4, here is A. So we're going to be looking at this side opposite A. However, I'm going to extend it out a little bit on the right-hand side. So now I'm going to make my 2 marks that are the same distance away from A, creating that line where A is directly in between those 2 marks because it is the same distance away from each. Now from there, I'm going to take my compass, adjust it to where it's a little more than halfway, make a mark from one intersection, switch to the other point, and make my other mark. Now, from vertex A through that intersection point, I can create my altitude. Let's continue on to the second page. For number 5 and 6, I'm going to be locating the orthocenter of each triangle. Now, the orthocenter is the intersection of altitudes. And in a triangle, we can create three altitudes. However, they're all going to intersect at that same point, the orthocenter. So we only need two to find that intersection. So let's get started in number five. In number five, I'll label my triangle A, B, C. So I'm going to start by finding the altitude associated with vertex A. Taking my compass, making marks on segment BC that are the same distance away from A, and then adjusting my compass so that it's little more than halfway between those intersections. I can then use that new intersection to draw my altitude. Now let's find the altitude associated with point B. I'm going to extend out AC so that I have a little more room to work off of that left-hand side. Now for B, I'm going to be intersecting my segment that I extended and then intersecting it again, making my compass a little more than half that distance. I'm going to strike a mark above that line from one point and then above that line from the other point. Now I'll draw my altitude. However, note that my altitudes did not intersect, so I'm going to have to extend up that first altitude that I drew associated with vertex A. So extending that, I will then eventually find my intersection point, which occurs outside of that triangle. That point is the orthocenter. Moving on to number six, I'll label my triangle X, Y, Z. So I'll find the altitude associated with vertex X at the start. So once I find that intersection point, I'll be able to create my altitude. Next, I'll find the altitude associated with Y. So I'm going to extend this line out a bit so that it's easier to see. Now from Y, I'm going to intersect line X, Z in two separate spots. And then, moving my compass to a little more than half that distance, I'll start from one of those intersection points, make a mark above, and then the other intersection point and make a mark above. Now I can draw my altitude through that intersection. So from Y through that intersection point. And remember, that's perpendicular with that segment XZ, but it's that extended segment, so that line XZ. And you can see that my intersection of the altitudes occurs at that point, which is the orthocenter. So I'll clean this up a bit so it makes it easier to see. Erasing some of my extraneous marks. There is the orthocenter. For numbers 7 and 8, it says for each triangle, construct all three altitudes to show that they are concurrent. Concurrent means that they will intersect at the same point. And we know this is true because that's what forms the orthocenter. So number 7, I'll label this triangle A, B, C. I'll extend out segment BC so that we can find the altitude associated with A. Taking my compass, I'll intersect that line BC at one point, and then I'll intersect it again at another point. Now that I have those two intersection points, I can find the perpendicular line that will run through vertex A. Making my compass a little more than half that distance, I'll strike to one side of the line from one intersection point, and then I'll mark again to the same side of that line from the other intersection point. That will help me create my altitude associated with vertex A. So from vertex A, I'll draw a line through that intersection to create my altitude. Now let's find the altitude associated with vertex B. I'm going to need to extend both sides of this line. So from B to line AC, I'll make one mark and then I'll make my second mark. Now that I have those intersection points, I can find a distance that's a little over halfway and strike to the same side from each of those intersection points. Now when I draw a line that connects vertex B to that point, that will be my altitude, which is perpendicular to side AC. And lastly, I'll find the altitude associated with vertex C. Extending AB, I'll start by placing my compass on vertex C, going out to that line, AB, making my first mark, then making my second mark. From there, I'll adjust my compass so that it's a little more than half of that distance between those two intersections, make a mark to one side of the line, AB, and then from that other intersection, make a mark to the same side of AB. Now, when I draw a line to connect vertex C to that new intersection, that will be my altitude, and it will run perpendicular to AB. And you can see that all three altitudes do indeed intersect at that same point, which is the orthocenter. Therefore, they are concurrent. Lastly, we'll look at the triangle in number 8. I'll name this triangle X, Y, Z. Starting with finding the altitude associated with vertex X, I'll intersect line YZ once, and then I'll intersect it again. Adjusting my compass to a point that's at least half of that distance, I'll strike a line to one side of YZ, and then strike a mark to the same side from that other intersection point, and then create my altitude. Now I'll see the altitude associated with Y. I'm going to have to extend out line XZ, and now I'll take my compass, place it on vertex Y, extend out to line XZ, intersect it once, and then intersect it twice. Now I'll adjust my compass so that it's a little more than half that distance, strike to the same side from each of those intersections. And from there, I can create my altitude that goes through vertex Y. Now note that I did not draw my first altitude long enough to where I can get that intersection, so I'm just going to go back and trace over, extending it out further. So here is going to be my orthocenter, or my point of concurrency. So now, when I find that altitude with vertex Z, it will go through this point. So extending out XY, the side that's opposite vertex Z, I'm going to start at vertex Z, intersect line XY, and then intersect it again. Now, from those intersection points on my compass, I'll adjust so that's a little more than halfway, make one mark, go to that other intersection, and make my final mark. Now, from point Z to that intersection, I can draw my altitude, which does indeed intersect that point of concurrency, which is the orthocenter. And with that, I'll wrap up the Altitudes of Triangles Constructions worksheet. If you have any questions, feel free to leave a comment below. Also, I recommend using different colors to help keep your altitudes separate from your perpendicular lines and other marks. And, as always, like, subscribe, and share.